The Lord is risen, he is risen indeed. Alleluia, alleluia. May the light of Christ scatter the fear and the darkness from our hearts and our minds. Amen. Good morning and welcome to St Cuthbert's on this, the first Sunday after Easter. We gather again around the Easter candle, thinking of that amazing moment of hope and joy in these challenging times when Christ appeared after his death at his resurrection, discarding the robes of death and turning the cross, a sign of defeat, now into a sign of victory, a victory that we all share from St Cuthbert's and indeed where everyone gathers to worship this Sunday morning. Scripture speaks of things beyond our seeing, prepared by God for those who love him, and these are what God has revealed to us through his Spirit. They who look to God are radiant with joy. They will never be put out of countenance. Let us pray. The collect appointed for this second Sunday of Easter. Almighty and eternal God, the strength of those who believe and the hope of those who doubt, may we who have not seen have faith and receive the fullness of Christ's blessing, who is alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. It will probably not surprise you that our collect points us in the direction of the story of Doubting Thomas, and that is the one which we will be exploring during the course of this service. But meanwhile, being the second Sunday of Easter, we normally would be welcoming the Bellringers for Belfry Sunday. They cannot be here and the bells are silent at the moment, but it doesn't stop us from making a short journey up into the tower for our prayers of approach and confession. So you join us under the ropes here in the bell tower. We're particularly thinking of Simon and his bell ringers, that great team who call us to worship and celebrate with us on all our festivals. Our prayers of approach and confession from the bell tower here at St Cuthbert's. Almighty God, you are God alone, and there is none like you, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders. You crown our lives with your love and compassion and satisfy us with good things. You pardon all our wrongdoing, heal all our ills, and renew our youth like the eagles. Therefore, we come eager to hear your word of forgiveness for the times and ways without number we have denied your goodness and betrayed your trust. Renew us by your Holy Spirit, that we may follow your way of love and kindness and serve you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and as a minister of his church, I declare to you who have confessed your sins to God that he of his love freely forgives you and absolves you from your sins, and offers you now the grace and comfort of his Holy Spirit. Amen. God of grace and glory, you speak to us in many different voices, sometimes in the whisper of a still, small voice of calm, sometimes in the uproar of earthquake, wind or fire. Today, we remember that you also summon us by bells. bidding us to worship, calling us to service, arousing us to witness. As the voice of the bells directs our hearts towards you, grant that their music may ever serve to remind us of how you have won the victory of good over evil, truth over lies, and light over darkness. We make our prayer through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now we will go down the spiral staircase and we will prepare to hear our readings from the Memorial Chapel. We continue this morning's service in the Memorial Chapel with our readings. The psalm will be read by Olivia, our shepherd scholar, who has been working with Young Church during this lockdown period. I just want to thank not just her, but like Young Church as well. They have produced some marvellous rainbows and crosses from paper, and using their vivid imagination have sent in some lovely photographs which will appear on the website. Olivia also gave a very inspiring reflection last Sunday as part of the St Cuthbert's team for the Edinburgh City Centre Churches Together Easter Sunday evening service, and that is also available on the website. Meanwhile, to Olivia for this morning's psalm.
A psalm from David when he fled from his son Absalom. Lord, how many are my foes? How many rise up against me? Many are saying of me, God will not deliver him. But you, Lord, are a shield around me. My glory, the one who lifts my head high. I call out to the Lord, and he answers me from his holy mountain. I lie down and sleep. I wake again because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear, though tens of thousands assail me on every side. Arise, Lord. Deliver me, my God. Strike all my enemies on the jaw, break the teeth of the wicked. From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessings be on your people.
Our thanks to Olivia for the reading. Our gospel reading comes from the Gospel according to St John. As I mentioned at the start of the service, we would be exploring the story of Doubting Thomas. And so this reading reminds us of that story and that event. But also, now is a good time, if you have been able to download or print off the painting by Caravaggio of Doubting Thomas, now would be a good time to get it out. And also, Oscar has kindly put it up on the website. So as I read from John's Gospel, do look at the painting at the same time, and it brings the story alive. Our Gospel reading from the Gospel according to St John, chapter 20, reading from verse 19. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained."
Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands and put my finger in the mark in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Amen, and thanks be to God for this reading from his holy word, and to his name be all the glory and all the praise. And now may the words of my lips and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. I think this Eastertide, perhaps more than any other, the story of Doubting Thomas has a real resonance with our current predicament as we continue in this lockdown state. You are being asked to believe that I am here, speaking to you, gathering us for this Sunday worship. But you physically are not here. I physically am not with you. Does that therefore make us doubting Thomases? Am I the doubter, imagining you are all still tucked up in your beds? Your mobile phones, your laptops have not been charging overnight, and that you're not with me as we share this worship. Are you the doubters, thinking he won't be there? He's probably enjoying the lie-in that we are all having at this time, not just on Sunday, but Monday, Tuesday, and throughout the week. So in a small sense, we have all become doubters at this time, not really sure of what is actually going on. But what of Thomas himself? If you look at the painting by Caravaggio, there is that real sense of presence. Caravaggio, perhaps above all the other great painters of his generation and time, was able to create a sense of the real physicality of a situation, whether that was Paul and his conversion experience on the road to Damascus, whether it was Christ being crucified on the cross, or perhaps my favorite painting, the painting on the road to Emmaus, when the two disciples suddenly realized who Christ was in the breaking of bread in that inn. One of the disciples threw out his arms in exclamation, in awe and wonder, realizing who this person actually was through the breaking of bread. And in this case, Thomas uses his hands to point into the side of Christ. Perhaps there is a link with the pointing finger, the finger that we think of Michelangelo's in the Sistine Chapel, depicting God giving life to us, mankind, Adam, with his fingers connecting. And that was picked up in the Gospel reading, with Jesus saying to his disciples, receive the Holy Spirit. You are being reborn with a new mission in mind to go out and preach the forgiveness of sins for all. So the pointing finger of God, bringing us alive once more, becomes in this case perhaps a pointing finger of John the Baptist, who has been part of our Easter story right through when we gathered at the beginning in Lent. John the Baptist pointing the way. John the Baptist pointing to Jesus to say that the story will now unfold with him. And here we are. This story is still unfolding. And it unfolds today with the finger of Thomas. But I think the amazing thing about this gospel reading isn't how vividly we see it depicted in Caravaggio's painting. It isn't the moment that Thomas places his finger in the side of Jesus that points us that we too should believe. It is that moment before he points the finger. It's that moment of recognition from Thomas when he says, "My Lord and my God." And do you realize he said that before he put his finger in Christ's side? In other words, it was the encounter with the risen Christ that brought the response from him, the response that he now fully believed and saw who this man was in front of him. That was so much more important than putting his finger in Christ's side. In many ways, the putting of the finger is a little add-on to the story. It is his huge sense of acclamation and joy in those words, "My Lord and my God." I said at the start of this reflection, we're not quite certain what is going on at the moment, whether worshipping remotely. We're not certain of where this virus is heading, but it is reassuring to see things stabilizing. But that makes it no less easier to cope with. But what we can be certain of are those words of Thomas, "My Lord and my God," because those are words that we can all say wherever we are, in any time and in any place. They are perhaps the most beautiful words to come out of this whole Eastertide. "My Lord and my God." Amen. And to God's name be all the glory and all the praise. As you know, we would normally take up an offering about now in our service. We're not able to do that physically, but technology does allow you to continue to give to the church remotely, online, or on the church website, where there is a giving page as well. Thank you for responding to our Easter letter and your kindness and your generosity. But if you are able to continue to give as usual, it will make all the difference so that when we gather again, we are complete. And so now the offering will be given in whatever way you choose to do so. And we will enjoy some music.
Thank you.
is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. Let us pray. Loving God, we give you thanks for your goodness and love towards us, for the joy of home and family, for the companionship of friends and neighbours, for the activities that fulfil our lives, for the strength that supports us and the love that surrounds us, both when our joy is complete and when it's touched by pain. We give thanks for your Son, Jesus Christ, for the glory of his humble birth, for the graciousness of his selfless life, for the obedience and trust that led him to the cross, and for the triumph of his resurrection and ascension. We give you thanks for your Holy Spirit at work in your church and in our hearts, revealing your truth, renewing our lives, and bringing us to your eternal kingdom. And now we go over to the Williams, who have been providing us with such beautiful prayers of intercession. Let us pray.
Through the risen Jesus, we have a living hope which will never spoil or fade. Let us pray. Father, we pray for your blessing on all throughout the world who worship you today. We pray for those who have yet to discover your love and their salvation. We pray for those who doubt your truth. We pray that our hearts may fill with love for all as the joyful news of Christ rings out over the land. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We bring to you, Lord, our hopes and prayers for the leaders of nations, our Queen and her governments and assemblies. Let their decisions and actions heal the divisions and conflicts which tear apart the peace of the world. We pray for an end to war and for safety and comfort for refugees and asylum seekers. We pray for those who work with energy, commitment and love to cure disease, often without the necessary equipment, medicine and facilities. God bless our National Health Service. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, bless our homes and families, especially those who must live in constantly cramped, overcrowded rooms to avoid infection. We acknowledge the joys and sorrows of relationships. We pray for the lonely and the frightened, for the vulnerable ones, and for those who feel hopeless. Let your love reach out to them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we pray for those who wake up to the prospect of another day filled with pain, for those who long for someone to spend time with them, enjoying their company. Grant them the patience and resilience to withstand the emotional frustration of isolation imposed by the coronavirus pandemic. We pray for those who love us to have the insight and empathy to notice their needs. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Gracious Lord, we give thanks for the creative talent and skill of the change ringers here at St Cuthbert's, who send out their message of praise, everlasting love and salvation every Sunday. We long for the end of the pandemic so that they may resume their art and greet our community and our city with the clarity of their peals. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We bring to you, Lord, those who approach death with fear and those who die unprepared to meet you. Have mercy on us all. Forgive us for all our shortcomings in the past and gather us into your everlasting kingdom of peace and joy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, we thank you for loving us right through death and into new life, and we rejoice in your victory over evil. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Now that we have created a pattern of recording the services and sharing them with you, if you would like to provide some of the readings, we can send those out to you, and then if you read them and send them back to us, we can incorporate them into our future acts of worship. Please continue to keep an eye out for one another. I've been so heartened by all the emails I've received and the updates from people, and how, as I say, people are keeping an eye out for each other and really are going the extra mile at this very difficult time. I am available, as always, on 0771 8311 319. Please do phone if you have any concerns, any worries, or if you just wish to share something with me. And now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all this day and forevermore. And the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit